I am Dr. Asha Kiran, Director, Takshana Ayurveda, Purnayu Bioscience Private Limited, Bangalore. Recently, we heard about a news brought out by a Delhi-based NGO named CSE about adulteration in honey by all the leading honey brands. I want to make my viewers literate about what is this issue of honey adulteration is all about. In this video, I am intending to make you aware about how all these issues arise, what were the tests conducted by them, how the investigations they carried out, what is the market response, what is the fact, what we should know, and how we can prevent ourselves from getting cheated. Is there any way left out for the consumer? These are the points which today we are going to discuss, the honey adulteration issue. So we are a small scale packers of honey called Queen Honey, Takshana Ayurveda Queen Honey. So being a manufacturer of honey or seller of honey, I was very keen on this news because what was the issue, how all this came out, wanted to know. You should be very keen, attentive, then only you should be able to understand what is this issue. I know you all are very much aware of this issue, but definitely there will be a lot of doubts. What is the real matter? See, here we can see two bottles. This is a brown liquid. It's a transparent liquid, you can see. A transparent liquid. Now, as soon as I came to know about this adulteration issue, I went through the NGO's website and got the report. This report, Laboratory Results of Honey Testing, CSE Study on Adulteration in Honey, December 2020. Who is CSE? CSE is called Center for Science and Environment. This same organization, few years back, have brought out reports about pesticides in carbonated drinks. I don't want to say the terminologies of other companies here because it is not ethical. So, the viewers, please do some research, which are the companies which are affected by this report. But I will be giving the nutshell, the brief about these issues, how the test was conducted and what happened. So it's a very reputed institution. They get crores of funding from various sources and they have disclosed this funding in their website, in the CSE website. This center is there in Tughlakabad institutional area, New Delhi. Now, one day morning last week, they published this report containing around 11 pages, which contains introduction, samples sent for testing, laboratory test results, the basics of that, all these results are there. So, who are involved in this issue? One, around 13 brands, big brands, whose honey is sold all over India. Their samples were taken, so they are there. Then another company, NGO is involved, CSE. Then definitely later, the licensing authority of India, FSSAI, also came into picture. This institute, CSE, is a NGO, it's not a non-governmental organization, took the samples of around 13 brands from the market and they sent it for quality checking to two laboratories. One is the laboratory called the Center for Analysis and Learning in Livestock and Food, CAF laboratory in Gujarat. Another laboratory is in Germany. They say a renowned food testing laboratory in Germany. They have not disclosed the name of the laboratory. What and all test they have done? They have, see, from the time immemorial, we know this honey is known for adulteration. In the streets and all, you can see some people will mix this sugar syrup, sugar syrup or jaggery syrup, and make into honey like that. But when it comes to renowned brands, definitely we will expect that they are giving some good, because which companies want to affect their branding? Definitely they won't do. This is what our, as a consumer, we expect. So this, in during this corona period, for the immunity purpose, the demand for honey increased. When the demand for honey increased, of definitely it is in huge tons, the demands all over India, all over world, the demand increases, and the supply also increased. Everywhere the honey was present. Then the CSC went to farmers and asked whether you are getting this demand, whether the people are coming and getting the honey from the real beekeepers. Then they said there is no much difference between the demand, the old demand, and after the corona. This is one hint which this NGO got, that there is some malpractice is happening. Then they decided to investigate this further. Second thing, the rate of this honey, the farmers which they get and the market honey, there is some variation. This honey is available in a very reasonable price in the market even after the demand, with a lot of free, 100 gram free, like that and all. So how this is possible? This was their concern. So definitely some malpractice was going on. We have to investigate that. This is what the motive this NGO got. They took the samples from the market in Delhi, and as I said earlier, they divided this into two packs, and one sent to Gujarat laboratory, one sent to German laboratory. They say that there are actually, they have given the list of the companies which they have given and all, which you can get from the, I don't want to tell the brand names of all this. So what they say is, overall 17 out of 22 samples were found to be adulterated. 22 samples they sent, out of that 17 were adulterated. Out of the 13 companies brand which they have tested, 10 were adulterated, 3 were passed. 3 passed. So what are the testing they have done? That also they say there are around 12 testing parameters which the Indian FSSAI has listed out for understanding the quality of the honey. See, understanding the quality of the honey is not so easy. We say you put some drops of honey in water, then if it goes down, that pure honey, otherwise if it mixes, see, this is in the olden days when people used to simply mix this sugar syrup and all, it was possible. Nowadays the technology has gone higher, that even the adulteration techniques have gone very in higher end. It's very, for the consumer it is very difficult, only with tasting or looking and all, we may not know the adulteration. So what are the testing parameters which they did? They are specific gravity, moisture content, total reducing sugars, sucrose level, FG ratio, total ash, acidity expressed as formic acid, free acidity equivalents acid per 1000 grams, hydroxymethyl furfural milligram per kg, diastase activity, water insoluble matters, pollen and plant matter count, proline milligram per kg, electrical conductivity. These are the 14 parameters they have checked. In these parameters, many samples got passed, many of got failed. And those who got all the pass, they did one more study called NMR study. This NMR study is not there in the Indian standards list of parameter checking. But still, this NGO did that because they got some hint that there is some kind of adulteration liquid. So here one such thing, this is not that exactly that adulteration thing. So when I came to know about all this from the market, we got some glucose syrup. This glucose syrup is available in the market. This is good, food grade liquid glucose. So what is this food grade liquid glucose? This is used for making syrups, making candies, making gels. Lot of use is there for this, especially for syrups making, and liquid glucose is used. Now similar kind of this one kind of syrup is imported from China, with and that is called as Alpas. Its code name is Alpas. What is this Alpas? That syrup will pass all the test parameters conducted by the laboratories for honey. So this is honey, this is syrup. Both if you send, this syrup will pass all the test. That is the Chinese syrup. So this NGO got some Chinese syrup samples also. They mixed this syrup with the honey. That also they sent. They got a pure honey from a farmer from Jaisalmer. From Jaisalmer they got some samples of pure honey from the beekeeper. That also they sent for samples. And they sent the pure honey, they sent the mixed adulterated honey, then they sent market samples, everything. So they came to know that there were different extent of adulteration. Say 25% adulteration, 50% adulteration, 75% of adulteration. They came to know that one company, one brand honey was adulterated with 75% of this Chinese syrup. Only the honey content was 25%. That sample got failed in most of the parameter testing. Those who mixed only like say 25% or less got pass in most of the parameters. But when they sent it, when they did the NMR studies, in the NMR study, the other companies, other brands who succeeded, who passed, whose samples passed all the tests in India, also failed. It was proven that that honey also contained adulterants. What was this adulterant? Whether any health issue is there for this adulterant is the next question definitely you will ask. See, glucose syrup, honey, there is a difference between its properties. People take honey for health improvement, for immunity. That purpose will not be served from a glucose syrup or a starch syrup. So the syrups are brought from sugarcane, from starch, with various forms of fermentation, with various chemical transformations. That will add to calories, but not for immunity, because honey contains pollen grains and a lot of other medicinal properties are there in the honey. But these are not there in the syrup. So in the name of honey, when we take glucose syrup, we add to our calories. That is one concern. Second, the consumer is getting cheated. These are the two things. So in the both ways, this is not a healthy thing. And how they are passing this test? This was the another concern. So more stringent parameters has to be implemented. This was the thing which this NGO wanted to convey to the government, convey to the consumers, that consumers should be more aware, more awake about this adulteration issue. And how, and then what happened after that? All these companies, most of the big brands, came with their own legal replies. They said that no, we do conduct the test and we give genuinely pure honey, it's not going, this is not correct, like that. Then came the FSSAI. They came and the FSSAI has asked the reports from this CSO, when CSE. This CSE has given their reports to FSSAI. This is what I have learned from the media. Now, this is the issue which is going on. So, my advice to my viewers is, see, adulteration is something which is happening from long. So, now here, how we can know? One thing is, we can go for local brands where you know, or honey beekeepers associations are there, from there you can take. So such things in a very conscious manner we should do, and definitely the government will do its stringent quality parameters something, and NGOs, this kind of NGOs work is really to be appreciated, because it brings a lot of awareness. So there are a lot of technical matters in this, which I don't want to discuss and make you more into confusion. there are few things which we have to be aware that are in the syrups. There are C4 sugars, C3 sugars. There are specific marker for rice. That is, if it is the syrup is from the rice starch, then the machines will come to know. The testing machines will come to know that if the sugar syrup is from the rice or it is from the sugar cane, like that. So these are the parameters which they have done. And now it is a hot topic which is going on. We have to see how the brands are counteracting and how they are going to take care of this issue of adulteration. And the consumers also should be more aware. So as a responsible brand, we give, you know, few honey samples to a few of this our patients who are coming here, and a few of our friends and non people. This is Queen Honey, which we have the FSSA license, and we also take care of lot of this quality concerns, how to safeguard the quality. This is a concern for every brand, there is no doubt in that. So with this, if you have any doubt further, how you can reply, we will try to make you more understanding about these issues. And if you like this, please share this to your friends, so that they will also be aware of this issue which is going on in the market. If you have any specific questions, please drop your doubts. We will definitely clarify it. Thank you.